What's the matter, Nikis?
I don't want to leave yet.
Well, we have to go home now, but I have a surprise for you.
Cool, is it ice cream?
It's better than that. Just sit tight.
Can you tell me how you stopped the mine again?
Are you sure you want to hear that story? You just heard it last night.
Please, Mom.
You've heard it so many times, you could probably tell it to me.
Yeah, I can. It was your last day of junior high and high school. You're sitting out front of the Menominee High School with your two best friends.
Jasmine, why are you so nosy? But seriously, who is he?
He's the head of the CLS program.
It's nothing, just something I did last summer.
You should definitely do it again. Treat yourself to paid vacay.
It's not like that. I said I'll help, but I don't want to. I guess I got him.
We pretty much know what we're doing this summer. We're gonna wrap it up. I hope we have a great summer this year. And 100% on finishing your project. Oh, Susan, glad you can join us. Everyone, this is Susan Weston, the writer I told you about.
Hi, Susan.
Okay, you have your assignments. I'll be emailing you tonight with research plans.
Late.
It's fine. You're here now. I want you to start investigating the energy inputs of the Front 20 mine proposal.
Is it possible I could continue working on the Preserving Oral Tradition project from last year?
Sorry, Susan, that topic's already been picked by Thomas. You can help preserve our language in another way, by protecting the site of our origin story. The secret's out, kid. You're one of the most talented writers around. The people need to hear your voice. Let me read you something. I want to help the people. I want to rebuild our relationship to the water, plants, and animals. We need a new understanding of power and energy, an understanding that comes from the wisdom of our ancestors that looks out for our great-grandchildren. That's from your essay, Susan. It made my wife cry when she read it. The people need to hear this voice.
I said I'll help and I'll do it, but I don't know about this.
We'll work together. You'll have help.
Also, Susan?
Yeah, I'm Susan Weston.
Hi, nice to meet you. My name is Mokini.
Nice to meet you.
Jeremy says you could use some help writing about the mine.
Yes, actually, I could.
Let's go to my office.
Powerful essay. I can see why Jeremy picked you. Well, looks like you need to compose a research paper. Have you done that before?
Yes, I wrote a 3-page research paper on photosynthesis this year.
Good. Who was your teacher?
Mrs. Stevens.
Did you just post this?
Yes, I did.
Me and the girls like to volunteer.
Good, we could use you. It's gonna take place 2 weeks from now. I'm just getting the word out a little early. People's busy summers, you know?
Okay, that'll be good. Lily just started a petition.
Oh, that's great. I know Lily and Jasmine. Hi, girls.
Hi, Miss Stevens.
Make sure to bring the petition along to the walk. You'll get plenty of signatures.
Are you cheating again?
Me? No.
Yeah, you.
Why would you say such a thing?
It's happened before.
I don't think so.
I think so.
No.
Haven't you seen it? Yeah.
I don't know what you're talking about.
He's been here the whole while. Ask him.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. What do you got going on there?
I found a real good one here. Aceley. A-C-E-L-Y. Aceley.
Dad, that's not a word.
Aceley.
Would it be in here?
Yes, I checked.
You checked?
Yes, I'm positive.
You're positive that it's in there?
A-C-E-L-Y, for
okay.
Sure.
Okay,
sure.
What does that mean?
Aceley, that's like deadly, you know, it's top of the line, it's the best.
It's the total best?
Yes. You can't do any better than Aceley.
I think we should involve Susan in this. She's the writer of the family. She could solve this argument.
Well, yeah, sure. All right, then I'll go get her.
Well, go get her.
Oh.
He's gonna be a while.
Yeah, he's getting old. That's okay. Forgive him.
You were sitting here watching him. Are you guys in cahoots?
No. I don't know what's going
on. Mm-hmm. Sure. Because if I looked in this book right now, would that word be in there?
Yeah.
No.
Come in.
Hey, Suze, how was your last day of junior year?
It was good.
Just good? What's the matter? It sounds like you're in homework mode.
Kind of. You remember that summer program I'm doing, the CLS? Well, I need to write a research paper on the proposed mine. The head of the program, Jeremy, just sent me a research packet to read. It's just a lot.
The Front 20 mine?
Yeah, they want to extract minerals, it looks like.
Your grandmother and I fought against mining.
Did you win?
Twice. As much as you can win against corporations anyway, they never go away. They bide their time, and now my granddaughter has to fight them. As much as we talk about seventh generation thinking, corporations have their own version.
How did you beat them?
I didn't. We did. The tribes, environmental groups, wildlife organizations, state senators, all different kinds of levels of government representatives, and all kinds of folks.
I have a ton of data to go through.
The more you know.
Hey, you think I could interview you for my paper?
It's possible, sure.
May I interview you for my paper?
Let's see. I'm busy this week. I was going to rebuild the dock tomorrow. If you could help me out with that, I'll give you an interview.
Deal.
Oh, yeah. Your grandma wanted me to let you know there's leftovers.
Okay. Thanks, Grandpa.
No problem, no say, sir. Try to get some sleep now, eh? It's a busy day tomorrow.
What do you think about my sketches for Javelin King's dress?
I think they're great, but you should probably use some more color.
What colors were you thinking?
Like a sky blue or lighter color.
Okay, I'll think about it, but I don't want it to be too over the top. I want people to be like, OMG, this is the greatest dress ever.
Yeah, hopefully Lambie and Alex pay us back so we can get more material.
Yeah, right? Otherwise I'll be bin diving again. Mr. Young, I hope you'll do your research on the long-term effect the mine will have on the environment when you do your environmental impact study.
I didn't come here to get preached to. I just come here to drop my son off for this walk for his summer school. I am contracted to do this study. I've been doing this line of work for many years now. Don't question my professionalism, Ms. Stevens, and I won't question yours. I just wanted you to know where I stand.
Nahao, Mr. Young. I appreciate you bringing Steven. I'm disappointed you won't walk with us to oppose this mine, but I guess we know where your loyalties lie.
I just made an offering to this water. We do that in order to pay respect to the life in this water. We make an offering in that bundle that includes gifts the Creator has given us, including tobacco, Menominee or wild rice, and maple syrup.
The bear was alone where the river empties into the bay. He called Eagle Thunders and said, Eagle, come be my brother. They were alone. The beaver requested to be taken into the totem of the thunders, being a woman called Beaver Woman. As they stood on the banks of the river, they saw a sturgeon who was adopted by the bear, the elk, who was adopted by the thunders as a brother and a water carrier.
Another time, bear was going up the river, resting at a waterfall, which emerged wolf. Then crane came by. Bear asked, crane, carry me to my people at the head of the river, and I will take you for my brother. Wolf called out saying, "Bear, take me as another brother. I am alone." This is how Crane and Wolf became brothers to Bear, but as Wolf permitted Doggy and Deer to join him, these three are now recognized as clans. Wolf is seated in the council on the north by Bear.
The Thunders visited the Bear village. They promised corn and fire in return for wild rice, which is property of the sturgeon and bear.
The Menominee people united at this time.
I'm sorry about my dad. You know, he's all about his work, and since this mining thing, it's just gotten worse.
Yeah, I know. But not everything's about money, you know. What do you think about this mine?
I don't know. You know, I don't really think anything about it.
Come on this side of me. You're supposed to be there anyways. Men are supposed to protect women.
Sorry, Auntie. Stupid tree.
Keep walking. Apparently that tree didn't hit you hard enough. Those maple trees are sacred to us, you know. They gift us with maple sugar.
I love maple sugar candy.
I love it too. It's one of my favorites. But people don't always like to do all the work that it takes to get it. They don't like to go gather the firewood and boil down all of the sap that takes just to get a little bit of maple sugar. But once they taste it, they love it. And then they know where their food's coming from. A lot of big food companies don't want us to know where our food is coming from. This reminds me of a story. It was the summer of 1999.
It was the spring of 1999. Jeremy Colt had just come home from an internship up in Bad River. He spent 6 months researching sturgeon.
Jeremy, come on, dinner's ready.
Where's Dad?
He's meeting with the dam representatives.
What? Mom, language.
You know what I mean.
I didn't know Dad was such a damn sellout.
Son, if some of our chiefs hadn't sold out way back when, we wouldn't have a reservation today.
It's not the same. If that dam goes up, the sturgeon won't be able to make it back to their original spawning grounds. The value of the environment outweighs the benefit of that dam.
Don't be so dramatic. Sturgeon can spawn on every river.
Actually, Mon, sturgeon are potamodromous.
Language.
Meaning? They must migrate back to their original spawning grounds.
Fish are fish. That dam will cut everyone's electric bill by 20%. You'd care if you paid any bills.
Namao is the first fish. Our ancestors, our existence, has always been intertwined with theirs for 10,000 years.
There you go, being dramatic again. You're 20. It's easy to be idealistic at your age. When your father and my age...
Idealistic? More like realistic. I have to go get ready for my presentations. I have to be pretty convincing tomorrow if I want to change some minds.
Say hello to your dad and Sean Young while you're there. They're coming to hear what you have to say.
Why is Sean Young coming?
Oh, your dad is working with him. He owns an environmental consulting firm. Weird thing, but I guess he makes good money. He does things to make sure that projects like the dam comply with EPA standards.
Well, that doesn't mean that they're doing what's best for the environment.
Pay a bill, Jeremy. It'll give you some perspective. Good night, son.
Good night, mother.
Thank you.
POSOH. I'm Jeremy Colt, a member of the Menominee Nation. I'm newly graduated from UW Stevens Point with a degree in limnology. I'm here today to talk about the proposed hydroelectric dam on the Menominee River. This dam is being proposed to provide a cleaner form of energy to the Menominee River area. The hydropower facility will impact the natural habitats of animals and plants in the surrounding area. There can be physical impacts, water quality impacts.
The Shawano and Balsam Road Dam have affected traditions that are kept by the Menominee people for tens of thousands of years.
We need to remember that all forms of energy have their downsides. And are these consequences really worth it? Thank you for listening to me. And if you have any comments, concerns, questions, or thoughts, or anything else, my contact information is at the back of the room. Thank you.
So Sean, how did you like the presentation?
All right. Could be a whole lot better, but hey.
Jeremy gave his presentation three different times. There was good information in there, but nobody seemed to care. Nobody seemed to, and it didn't seem to make a difference.
Why? What happened?
Well, the way Jeremy told it to me, the dam company suppressed his information from his research. They didn't want the public to know about it.
It's messed up.
Yeah, it is. The dam went in, and now Namao can't get home. Jeremy's been waiting for an opportunity like this. I think he sees this mine as his chance.
What a great day for a water walk. Are you going to put that thing away and enjoy this gorgeous day?
What? Sorry, I was just...
I'm just giving you a hard time. What are you doing on that contraption that's more important than carrying life itself?
I had to look something up for my CLS energy project.
You know that what's in the batteries is part of the problem. The container that they use to house that battery is what they're proposing to take out of the ground. Anyway, a few years ago at the college on Earth Day, Makanit had a presentation. Oh yeah, wait.
How you doing?
Good. Can you stand here?
Yes, I can, but I think you have to hear. Makanee, we have a student.
Hello.
So the idea is to store and conserve surplus electrical energy from renewable systems through the methanation process, creating methane gas. I hope to practice our sovereign rights by creating larger units that could power more than just a single home. Hopefully, it could power a whole neighborhood.
What's that?
That is a model of that, and that explains what it is. It's gonna help with energy. So here's your passport.
So what does this have to do with my cell phone anyways? And where did the van go?
They went to get more walkers. I'm getting to it. The kids were there, then, oh yeah.
Sorry I had to miss my presentation before.
Oh yeah, what was it about?
I talked about my plan to move the reservation towards energy independence. Independence of transportation, residential, electrical, and beyond. Once that happens, we can scale up and affect change in local communities, and someday the world. If we could only find efficient renewable energy sources, even then we'll still need to change.
Or something like that. The point being, there's no magic bullet that's going to solve all our energy needs.
And this has what to do with my cell phone?
I'm getting to that. Makanit's idea was great. She ran into funding problems, so she went to find money. Sunyan.
And together we can help shape our sovereign energy policies for our tribal nations.
Thank you, Makani, for coming to see us today.
Thank you. Are there any questions?
Okay, actually, I do have a question. Will these units meet the increasing energy demand of our community?
Yes, I think so. There's two sides here, supply and demand. It's an equation. One side is the electricity these units can realistically provide. The other is the electricity habits of our community. The policies we create together can help strike the balance between the two.
Mamma! Sturgeon!
It's July, Grandpa. There aren't any sturgeon here now.
Oh, huh? Yeah, right. Anyway, long story longer, Mopinit's invention was shelved. She couldn't get the funding she needed because she couldn't guarantee that it would work on a larger scale. But I think it would if we had enough wind, enough solar, and a steady supply of cow poop. It could work.
Steven, why is your dad being such a jerk to Steph this morning?
I don't know. He's been mean to everyone lately, even Auntie.
Well, that's messed up.
Hey, can you give your mom the baby? I gotta tell something. Tell you guys something. Please.
Wait, what is it? Oh, I saw your dad do some shady stuff the other night.
What?
Yeah, Alex, show him.
Why are you guys seriously like always hitting on my dad, you know?
Did you say hitting on?
Sweet.
Thanks, dude. I've been working on that for a while. Whoa, did you hear that?
Yeah.
Let's go check it out. Who's there?
Ah! What the heck, bro?
Bree, Rose, what are you guys doing here?
Well, well, well. Look who it is. Alex Garcia and Lambert Jones. Where's our money?
Yeah, where's our money?
Where's your money? What are you even doing here?
I thought you were raccoons.
Raccoons? What would raccoons be doing here? And don't change the subject, you owe me $50.
Yeah, me too.
Ladies, let's not fight. Obviously none of us should be here. Let's just go about our own business and act like we didn't see each other.
Fine, just as long as you guys stop filming us doing our thing.
Okay, seriously though, but why are you guys even here?
Because you took all of our money. We have to find other ways of acquiring new materials for our fashion line.
Fashion line? You guys are high schoolers, you can't have one.
Guys, do you hear that?
Who says we can't? We've already designed clothes for Javelin King.
Javelin King? You're lying. Why would she want?
Guys, shut up.
What?
Hi.
Is it the cops?
Who else would be out here after hours?
Guys, I think that's Steven's dad's car. I'm gonna go check it out. Oh man, Steven's dad.
Hopefully this small donation will ensure that the environmental studies will go our way. Go.
Man, I can't. I'm sorry.
What was that?
What was what?
So what happened? Did you guys get caught or?
Nah, we booked it.
Yeah, we dipped out.
Where's that video at? Can you forward me the link to it?
Yeah, it's on Lambie's YouTube channel. Man, had a little Lambie 2000.
Alright.
Yeah. Oh, it's your dad. Sorry. Bye.
Son, I need to talk
to you. I gotta show you something. I saw something pretty messed up.
Oh, what are you talking about?
I'm talking about this.
Hello everyone, thank you for being here. I'm Stephanie Stevens. I'll be introducing our speaker tonight. But first I wanted to take time to thank all those who participated in our water walk a few weeks ago. I'd like to introduce an amazing lady. She's been fighting for Indigenous sovereignty rights for years. Thank you.
I'm honored to stand here with you all today. My concerns are the same as yours. We are aware of the massive consequences that will come from the Front 20 mine. The Menominee people will be affected, but also the Menominee River. A remarkable young Menominee woman impressed me during my short time here. Susan Weston, a high school student and also a CLS member, could not be here tonight to read her paper. Her cousin, Stephen Young, has volunteered to read her introduction to her paper.
No matter where we stand on environmental protection, each of us needs energy to power the devices that run our lives. The first step in raising awareness, and each of us play a role. Some of us practice the three R's: reduce, reuse, recycle. Some started a petition and asked people to sign it.
Thank you, Muffin.
Some
evolved
activists.
Others use technology to expose corruption.
Go.
Man, I can't. I'm sorry.
Some informed the community through years of research, striving to influence policy. Volunteered their time. Would have been easier not to. I pay respect to those who use our ways and keep the people strong in our beliefs. Finally, we must recognize the people in our community who have taken the initiative to bring us all together. I know I'm not alone. And this community's actions are proof that together we can do it.
Listen, son, I didn't take that bribe. In fact, I came here to join you and the rest of the community. I can, in good peace of mind, go with that plan.
You didn't take it at all? You didn't?
No, I didn't.
Wow, you do know that story. Next conference, you should be the keynote speaker.
Thanks, Mom. Where are we?
This is it. This is where the mine would have been if we wouldn't have stopped it.
Wow, this is beautiful. Now I know why we had to protect it.
That's only part of the reason, Nikits. Someday when you bring your own children out here, you'll understand why we have to protect what's sacred to us.